today in particular, I would like to say a few words about what we've been doing in the education, what we're still doing, what we do with the program Erasmus, which is one of the most important education programs of the EU, and also to address the aspect of social inclusion, especially in education, but more in general in society.
Danas bih rekao nešto više o samoj temi obrazovanja, također o projektu Erasmus koji je jedan od najvažnijih obrazovnih programa, također i nešto o socijalnoj inkluziji, o inkluziji u obrazovanju, ali prije svega o društvenoj inkluziji.
But before starting with our financial assistance, I think it's important to understand why the EU presence and the EU financial assistance in this country is so special and different from any other intervention of other donors.
Prije nego što kažem nešto više o financijskoj pomoći Europske unije, htio bih reći zašto je nazočnost Europske unije i njezine financijske pomoći u Bosni i Hercegovini posebno u odnosu na neke druge donatore.
So the European Union is not here simply to finance a project, to implement it and then to leave and go to the next one.
Europska unija nije ovdje samo da financira neki projekt, da ga okonča i da pređe na sljedeći.
So the objective is much deeper and much more longer term. There is a European integration perspective. So whatever we are doing here, not only through the financial assistance, but also through the policy dialogue, it has an objective, which is finally the integration of Bosnia and Herzegovina in the European Union.
Naš cilj našeg djelovanja je zapravo puno širi, puno dugoročniji, jer trebamo imati u vidu perspektivu europske integracije, znači kroz jedan dijalog da ostvarimo taj jedan širi i dugoročni cilj integracije Bosne i Hercegovine u Europsku uniju.
And I think this is very important to understand, otherwise we cannot understand why it is a partnership. So it's a very special kind of relation between the European Union and Bosnia and Herzegovina. And the final target, the aim, is to get to the accession. Of course, it's a long path. There are a lot of obstacles. We had obstacles in the past. We still have obstacles, but we are moving. And I think what happened on the last Monday with the submission of the application, the formal submission of the application to become a membership of the European Union, I think we had really a turning point in these relations. It's a very important point. It's not the end, it's just the beginning, but it's a very important step.
Zbog toga je važno razumjeti da Bosna i Hercegovina i Europska unija imaju jedan vrlo poseban odnos, a to je partnerski odnos, sa jednim krajnjim ciljem, a to je da Bosna i Hercegovina se pridruži Europskoj uniji. Naravno, na tom putu postoje velike prepreke, imali smo ih i u prošlosti, još uvijek ih imamo. Mislim da je prošli ponedjeljak ostvaren jedan veliki napredak kada je Bosna i Hercegovina službeno podnijela svoju aplikaciju za članstvo u Europskoj uniji. I to je jedan novi početak.
So when it was talking about the partnership, this is really the way we have to explain our dialogue in relation between the European Union and Bosnia and Herzegovina. It means that more than coming with some pre-prepared solutions and products for our financial system, we come here to try to support the strategies and to try to support the efforts in terms of reform in all sectors. And this also applies to the, in particular, in the education sector.
Kada sam ranije pomenuo partnerstvo, htio sam reći da je to način na koji mi objašnjavamo dijalog između Bosne i Hercegovine i Europske unije. Mi nismo tu da donesemo nekakva već određena, već postojeća rješenja, nego da pomognemo u donošenju strategija i u provođenju reformi u različitim sektorima, jedan od njih je obrazovanje.
This is important because this is a way we are allocating our financing through a dialogue with the government authorities. Notably, our entry point is the Directorate of European Integration, which depends by the Council of Ministers. But then there is a dialogue at all levels, and with all institutions which are involved in a particular sector.
Upravo na taj način mi usmjeravamo svoju financijsku pomoć kroz jedan dijalog, s tim da je naš institucija s kojom primarno razgovaramo i kroz koju ta pomoć pristiže, Direkcija za europske integracije, ali surađujemo ne samo s njom, nego i sa drugim institucijama na različitim razinama.
So, this is why this is the way we are working in this particular sector. It's also important to understand that from 2014 we have a new instrument. So in our jargon we say that we are under IPA 2, which means the instrument for pre-accession number 2, which covers the period 2014-2020.
Od 2014. godine također imamo jedan novi instrument za našu pomoć. Mi u našem žargonu kažemo da se sada nalazimo u IPA 2, a to su zapravo sredstva iz tih to su predpristupna sredstva i taj projekt IPA 2 traje od 2014. do 2020.
And one of the features of this new instrument, it is a focus on the sector approach. So it means whatever we do in a particular sector, it has to be coherent, it has to be integrated, it has to be part of an effort to implement a real substantial reform in that sector. So it has to be part of a strategic framework, and it has to have a goal which is to achieve the overall reform in that particular sector. So it cannot work as an isolated project, but it is part of supporting strategies in a particular sector.
U okviru tog projekta IPA 2 mi smo usvojili jedan sektorski pristup rada, što znači da u promjenama, reformama u određenom sektoru pristupamo integrirano, koherentno, da se u tom sektoru mora provesti jedna značajna reforma, znači da se ne radi o nekakvim izoliranim projektima, nego da mora doći do jedne veće, sveobuhvatnije reforme u cijelom tom sektoru.
So, very briefly, I would say a little bit about what we've been doing as far as the education sector. We started many years ago, and only in IPA 1, which is the former period, we invested about 12 million euros in the support to the reforming the education sector.
Sada ću reći nešto o tome što smo do sad radili u području obrazovanja. U okviru ranijeg projekta IPA 1 mi smo u obrazovanje uložili 12 milijuna eura.
It is a very wide area of work and we're covering many different aspects of the education. In the past we've been supporting the vocational education training, but we also address what we call the qualification frameworks. It is a very important element because there is a European qualification framework and it's extremely important to support the possible mobility to the European Union when it comes to work, and also to have a better comparability when it comes to the diploma and the degree.
Obrazovanje je jedno vrlo široko područje. Mi smo prije svega do sad radili u oblasti stručnog obrazovanja i usavršavanja. Također radimo i na izradi kvalifikacijskog okvira, budući da postoji kvalifikacijski okvir. Rad na kvalifikacijskom okviru u Bosni i Hercegovini bi omogućio veću prohodnost, odnosno mobilnost ljudi, kao i mogućnost usporedbe stečenih kvalifikacija i diploma.
But we didn't stop there. There is a lot of work which has been done on the regulated professions, work to support the improvement of the quality in the higher education. And another very important element is also support to the entrepreneurial learning.
Nismo se zaustavili na tome. Uradili smo dosta u oblasti reguliranih zanimanja. Također, na poduzetničkom učenju. I još jedna oblast u kojoj smo radili jeste osiguranje kvalitete u visokom obrazovanju.
The question of entrepreneurial learning is particularly important. Why? Because we are not supporting the education in itself as a sector in isolation. The reason why we're supporting is because we need to build link between the education and the economy. Because in the end, the purpose is to improve the employability. So to allow the better perspectives in terms of job creation and the job opportunities. So this is really ultimately the goal of what we're doing in the education system.
Posebno se osvrćem na poduzetničko učenje. Zašto je ono važno? Zbog toga što je važno uspostaviti vezu između obrazovanja i gospodarstva, jer to omogućuje stvaranje radnih mjesta i otvara više mogućnosti za zapošljavanje.
And this is also the field of work for the future programming. So we are right now in the preparation of our programming for 2016 and 2017. And that will remain one of the focus. So the employment in itself, which also is seen from the perspective of the education. So how the education can be better linked to the economy so that there is better employability. And in doing that, how can we take care also the more vulnerable groups of the society. So how we can ensure the social inclusion when we support the education.
Taj rad na poduzetničkom učenju predstavlja jednu vrstu terenskog rada. Mi trenutačno pripremamo naše planove za 2016. i 2017. godinu i prije svega se fokusiramo na upošljavanje iz perspektive obrazovanja, odnosno kako uspostaviti tu vezu između obrazovanja i upošljavanja koja će dovesti do boljeg upošljavanja. A druga stvar na koju se fokusiramo jeste kako uključiti osobe iz ugroženih skupina u sve to.
So, in addition to this, I would like to say a few words about Erasmus. Because I think among all the programs of the European Union, this is a really special, it has a special role and a special position. I think there are no other programs globally which have contributed so much altogether to the construction and the building of the European Union spirit.
Sada bih rekao nešto o programu Erasmus, koji je jedan zbilja poseban program i mislim da globalno gledano ne postoji drugi program koji je toliko doprinio stvaranju tog nekog duha Europske unije.
There is a link between our financial systems in Bosnia and Herzegovina, what we call the IPA allocation, or the instrument for reaccession, and the Erasmus Plus.
Postoji veza između naše financijske pomoći Bosni i Hercegovini, odnosno tih predpristupnih fondova i programa Erasmus Plus.
Because through the instrument for reaccession, we support the co-financing of the entry ticket to participate to the Erasmus Plus program.
Jer mi kroz IPA fondove upravo doprinosimo jednom ulasku sudjelovanje u programima u okviru Erasmusa.
It is a small allocation. It is about 100,000 euro per year. But this is what allows a full participation both in Herzegovina into this program.
Za sad su sredstva predviđena za program za podršku ulasku u program Erasmus dosta mala, radi se od svega oko 100.000 eura godišnje, ali to ipak omogućuje Bosni i Hercegovini da sudjeluje u tim programima.
So, then the opportunity is there. It means that students, it means that professor, researcher, even technical staff from the higher education can participate and they can have the opportunity to enlarge their experience and to spend some time. They can go from 1 or 2 months to a full period of 2 years in a partner country, in the European Union or in another of the countries who are participating to this program.
Kada se omogući ulazak u Erasmus projekt, otvaraju se zbilja mnoga vrata, tako da studenti, profesori, oni koji rade istraživanja, čak i tehničko osoblje sa visokoškolskih institucija mogu sudjelovati u tim programima, odnosno odlaziti u posjete drugim visokoškolskim institucijama, tamo provesti od mjesec, dva dana do 2 godine ili u nekoj od europskih zemalja ili u nekoj, odnosno zemalja Europske unije ili u nekoj drugoj zemlji koja nije u Europskoj uniji, ali je dio programa Erasmus.
It is an extraordinary opportunity. Having been part of the program myself many years ago, when it was really at the beginning, I can say how much it helped to open my eyes and to see that the way the education and my institution in the higher education was working was not the only possible way, but there are different systems, totally different, and it gives, most important than anything, it gives the possibility to have an exposure to a different culture, to learn a different language, to understand people who are coming from different contexts.
To je jedna zbilja iznimna prilika. Ja sam također prije mnogo godina sudjelovao u projektu Erasmus i on mi pomogao da otvorim oči, da vidim da postoje različite obrazovne institucije, da možda ona na kojoj sam ja tada studirao nije najbolja, da postoji jednostavno drugi način da se stvari rade. To omogućuje studentima da posjeti drugu zemlju, da nauči drugi jezik, da se upoznaju sa nekom drugom kulturom.
And this is why I am so pleased that the participation was in Herzegovina in this program in Erasmus Plus, because it has been very successful and there have been a very numerous participation in the program. We had recently the statistics and the data from the participation to the last call, and we have seen that about 600 students and professors will be able to move during this academic year, 2015-2016, and the possibility to make an experience in a different country.
Moram još jednom naglasiti koliko je značajan ovaj program Erasmus Plus. Nedavno smo dobili neke statističke podatke o njegovim rezultatima, ali evo samo ove akademske godine oko 600 studenata i profesora će ostvariti tu mogućnost da odu negdje drugo.
Bosnia and Herzegovina has been, according to the statistics, the 10th receiver in terms of allocation and funds, in terms of participation to Erasmus Plus. So I think it is really an extraordinary result. In some areas, it has even been the first. When we look at this region, for instance, there is one of the actions is called Jean Monnet. It supports specifically programs in the field of European integration. And here, Bosnia and Herzegovina has been able to win two proposals. It has been successful in two proposals, and that was also the most successful results in the region.
Po nekim rezultatima, Bosna i Hercegovina je, s obzirom na pomoć koju prima u okviru ovog programa, otprilike na 10. mjestu i postigla je zbilja sjajne rezultate, čak u nekim oblastima je bila i prva. Postoji jedan podprogram koji se zove Žamone, posebno se fokusira na europske integracije. Nedavno su usvojena dva prijedloga koja je podnijela Bosna i Hercegovina i dakle u ovoj regiji je ona na prvom mjestu što se tiče sudjelovanja u tom podprogramu.
So I would really like to encourage everybody to look at the opportunity and to try to see what it is on offer for them. Both for students but also for academic staff, for researchers, staff of the higher university.
Tako da bih ohrabrio sve i studente i osoblje koje radi na visokoškolskim institucijama da razmotre koje im se sve mogućnosti otvaraju kroz ovaj program.
So finally, I would like to say a few words about social inclusion, because we shouldn't forget these very important aspects when we look at the education and the social sector in general. Social inclusion is key. So it's not enough that we have a good education system. We should continue to work on improving the quality of the education system, but we should also make sure that everybody can have access to this system, including people with disabilities, in particular children with disabilities, children without parental care.
Na kraju bih rekao nešto o društvenoj inkluziji koja predstavlja vrlo važan aspekt i u obrazovanju i u samom društvu. Ovdje postoji jedan dobar obrazovni sustav i ono što je važno u tome jeste osigurati da svi imaju pristup tom obrazovnom sustavu. Osobe sa invaliditetom, djeca bez roditeljskih skrbi i sl.
And we have also our partner here, representative of UNICEF. UNICEF UNICEF has been a very important partner in the implementation of the project, which we started from 2008. It's what we call the SPIS, so Social Protection and Inclusion for Children system, which we funded for an amount of 4.5 million euros overall. 4.5.
Ovdje danas imamo i predstavnika UNICEF-a koji je vrlo važan partner u provedbi ovog projekta vezanog za društvenu inkluziju. Od 2008. godine traje projekt SPIS. To je projekt koji se bavi socijalnom zaštitom i inkluzijom djece. Dosad je Europska unija u njega investirala 4,5 milijuna eura.
So the program came to an end in December 2014, but it had achieved a lot of results, in particular when it comes to the institutionalization of social protection policies in the field of development of modern social protection services, and also in the delivery of specific support for children with disabilities.
Je projekt okončan u prosincu 2014. godine, ali je imao vrlo značajne rezultate u institucionalizaciji odgovarajućih politika socijalne zaštite, zatim razvoja suvremenih usluga socijalne zaštite i također u daljem razvoju konkretne podrške djeci sa invaliditetom.
So, but our activities are not finishing here. And we've already started a new program. We signed a contract in December 2014 for what we call the transformation of the institution. And we will continue to support this very important sector with a contract which has an EU funding of 1 million euros. And this will be focused in particular on the what we call the transformation of the institution. So, to try to experiment alternative possibilities to the residential treatment of children, in particular children with disabilities. Because we know that the majority of children without parental care are also children with disabilities.
Naše aktivnosti ne završavaju ovdje. Mi smo u prosincu 2014. godine također potpisali jedan ugovor koji financiramo sa 1 milijun eura. Vezan za transformaciju institucija, odnosno tražimo neke alternativne mogućnosti boravka djece sa invaliditetom. Većini je poznato da su djeca bez roditeljske skrbi, obično i djeca s invaliditetom.
So I would like to stop here. I think it was long enough and would be very happy actually to reply to possible questions or engage into a little bit of the debate. And together with me also, my guest, Mrs. Yadranga Mihic, is our expert on education and health issues. So if you have any other question about what we are doing, what project we have been implementing in the past, what we are planning to do in the future, don't hesitate to just contact us. You can send an email to directly to us or to our information center.
Ne bih duljio, prepustio bih i drugim kolegama da nešto kažu. Biće mi drago da odgovorim na moguća pitanja i sudjelujem kasnije u diskusiji. Pored mene sjedi moja kolegica Jadranka Mihić koja je naš stručnjak za obrazovanje i zdravstvo. I ako imate bilo kakvih pitanja, uvijek se možete obratiti našem uredu, e-mailom ili telefonom. Hvala.